on the Wing Chun. So we're going back to the Chi Sao setup. I'm gonna break this down for you a little bit. So in the Mukjong form, you have a particular strike, the Buji strike. So when we're coming across like this, if he's throwing a punch, and what we're going to do, we're using the snake and crane principle from the Wing Chun. So when I'm working this defense, his straight line snake-like attack, point A to point B, is coming into play. So what I need to do is I need to be in line with his motion. So as he's coming in, I have to follow that particular pattern, be slightly ahead of it, but not too much. I only have to be ahead of it in order to direct it. So when we're working this, all I'm doing, and if you look at my elbow, so when I'm doing this motion, it's like this. I don't bring my elbow out. People will take their elbow and they'll pull their elbows out, and it's like, not good. What we want to do is we want to take it from this. Think about the wingtip of the crane's wing, just like that, how it's curled out, and we bring it here. We're basically taking the shot, and we're using it at the curve of the thumb here, and we're directing it off of center line. And I emphasize this just to show path, not to show technique. Technique is here. I bring it closer to my side. So when he throws that punch, we're looking at this, and he can feel the pull on this. You can feel how the body gets pulled along on this. And then I return the strike back to the eyes. So that comes in, I want to be in time with what he's doing. And it's not a motion, so if we're using this one, it's not a motion where my fingers come down and I hook. Because what we're doing, we're going to eye strike. So the most efficient way to go from an eye strike is from here, straight back to the eyes. So I want to make sure that as I'm doing this, I only go down so far as I need to. If I go down here, it's wasted space. Yes, I can get the punch in there, but I took too long doing it. By that point, yeah, that one right there should be coming in to hit me. So at that point, then I have to be able to get this back in time, tansao or whatever else I happen to do. So I want to be able to do just enough to clear so that my strike coming forward is clear. So there's just enough so that my elbow, and you'll get the sense for this as you're working this, and the more relaxed I am on this, the better. So we'll train it just like this for a bit, like that for a bit, that for a bit, and this for a bit. That type of mentality. So there's no finger involvement. And your partner, we're gonna have your partner. If your partner's super, super tense, they're gonna feel that really quick. The nerve is gonna be hit on that pretty hard. So yeah, so the more relaxed they are and the more they are centered in their Wing Chun base, yeah, the less you'll be able to pull them off. There we go. And now we're working toward center line, feeling that. There we go. Now we're looking, that's efficiency. So the next point is he's going to go to Bong Sao. So actually, I'll throw the strike. If I throw the strike and he does the Fook Sao close like that to the Buji strike, as he does the Buji strike, I'm gonna go to Bong Sao. The Bong Sao itself, if you're looking at it from this direction, if he's throwing the punch straight at me and I rotate my wrist, that's all I'm doing. If I'm adhering to this as it's coming in the proper time, you can see the direction. We can see directly as it comes in. All I'm doing is rolling my fist and I'm turning it towards center line. You can see how that mechanical action actually moves it off center line. I am still keeping my fingers towards center. I'm not doing this. I'm not rotating this out. So if I catch this right on its incoming motion, it changes its pathway out to here. And I don't have to move my body. This is all I'm doing. So he's going up that inclined plane, it changes that path. So once he feels that, he's just gonna keep his elbow a little bit more relaxed, because what I'm going to do is work inside strike, but he's going to close that line with the Fook Sao. So I come here like this, and he goes up to the Buji. I turn it like this in anticipation of coming back in. I'm gonna clear that strike. So if he's up here like this on the strike, I'm gonna clear that strike with the Tan Sao, whipping it out and then back into center line. But he's on to me. So, and he's on to me because he feels here. So he's gonna reduce his elbow presence. He's gonna close it in. I'm gonna tansao. And notice that this movement, so when we're back up to here, as soon as I go to tansao, he feels this. He's not ahead of me, he's not behind me. And he closes the line. So he makes that so that I can't enter along center line. So we're looking at his center. That's where I wanna go, but now he's got this little path, that block. So that's how we're judging this, is that elbow to fingertip. Yeah, I can't make this without him being able to deflect that with just the slightest movement. So we're looking back at that. So I throw the punch, he goes to there, I go back to here, we're in the fook sao position, and then we reset. And I'll throw it again, we go back here, back to here. And once more, punch, center line, back, and we're here. So now if you look at this particular position, we go back to here, that's a strike on that side, right? That's a strike, and I'm back in the same position. I want to go tansao, so I go here, he sets it down. He goes to strike on this side, goes to strike, I go here. And then he sets it back on and relaxes it on there. So this is the chisao. So when you're looking at that particular motion on how we get that, those basic elements that make that up, it's this strike coming in. I'm first coming into the outside wing, the crane wing, against the snake strike, and then the beak. You have to then turn this into the beak on the crane. And then he'll turn because he'll feel that, and it changes his own. He goes back to the being the crane this time. His wing comes out and opens it up. And it works just like that. So that's the crane and the snake, basically from the Wing Chun element, which turns out to become the Bong Sao, Lop Sao, or Bong Sao, Tan Sao position, or the Chi Sao position. That's what makes this really, really cool.